Developing video games as an independent studio is almost always risky. The health of a studio depends on the success of its games, and just one misstep or failure can result in a death sentence, which is what makes Obsidian Entertainment all the more remarkable. Founded in 2003, Obsidian has survived multiple project cancellations, poor launches, and a financial crisis that would have sunk any other studio. Along the way, it survived by making several cult classics, became one of the first developers to take advantage of crowdfunding, before ultimately securing its future in the hands of Microsoft. Today on Game Files, we're taking a look at how Obsidian Entertainment charted a course through the hell that is game development to find a future where its next game wouldn't make it or break it as a company. Obsidian's origins begin with the collapse of another studio, Black Isle. The developer was known for its suite of successful role-playing games, such as Baldur's Gate 2, Planescape Torment, and Fallout. While the studio was doing well, its publisher, Interplay Entertainment, was not. After the cancellation of Baldur's Gate 3, The Black Hound, key figures from Black Isle left shortly before it collapsed to create Obsidian. It took a few months before the new studio was approached by LucasArts to make a sequel to Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic. It was set for release in holiday 2004, giving Obsidian just 15 months to develop it. Against all odds, and with some help from LucasArts staff, Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic 2, The Sith Lords, was released on time. However, numerous features and content had to be cut in order to get it released, and the game was plagued by crashes and technical issues. In short, it was a preview of what was to come in Obsidian's future. Fortunately, its next game was not rushed. In partnership with Atari, who has acquired the Dungeons & Dragons license, Obsidian developed Neverwinter Nights 2, its second game, and coincidentally, its second sequel to a game made by BioWare. Atari even delayed the game a full year in order to let Obsidian take its time. And while it still had bugs when it launched in 2006, at least most of the content wasn't cut. Obsidian's next game wouldn't be released for 4 years, but it wasn't because of a long development cycle. Multiple projects were started and canceled, including a Snow White and the Seven Dwarves RPG and a game based on the Alien franchise. 4 years without a release changed into 2 new games in the span of a year come 2010. Unfortunately, both suffered from rough development cycles. The first game, Alpha Protocol, was a spy RPG published by Sega that did not have a precise vision as to what it wanted to be, suffering from half-baked features. It's a cult classic that you can no longer purchase due to its music licensing issues. The second is more tragic. Fallout New Vegas is a great game, but it wasn't thoroughly checked for bugs and crashes. These were fixed in a matter of weeks, and New Vegas has since come to be regarded as a great RPG. But the disastrous launch state that came about because of the lack of familiarity with Bethesda's engine meant that Obsidian lost out on company bonuses by 1 Metacritic point. At this point, Obsidian was in panic mode. Its next title, Dungeon Siege 3, didn't perform as well as the studio expected. And though South Park: The Stick of Truth was in development, a change in publisher meant that Obsidian was running on fumes. To survive, Obsidian had to try something few had done before. Enter Kickstarter. Obsidian took a chance on the crowdfunding platform to try and get money to develop an original RPG, Pillars of Eternity. Developers wondered if they would even get $100,000. In the end, Obsidian raised over $4 million. Disaster was averted. The studio's success with crowdfunding would result in 2 more projects being greenlit with the method: Pillars of Eternity 2, Deadfire, and Tyranny. In the meantime, Obsidian finally launched the South Park game after a long development cycle. Smaller games, such as the free-to-play MMO Skyforge and card game RPG Pathfinder Adventure, also kept Obsidian busy. But after surviving a near closure, stability was sought. And in the late 2018, Microsoft announced that it had acquired Obsidian to make it a part of the Microsoft Studios division. But the studio had one last independent game up their sleeve. The Outer Worlds is an RPG that evokes modern Fallout games, with a sci-fi setting filled with mega corporations and dangerous monsters. Its release in October 2019 marked the end of Obsidian as an independent developer. Now, the studio is hard at work on Grounded, a survival game where you play as a child shrunk to a microscopic size. Obsidian has endured numerous challenges to make it where it is today. As for what the future holds, neither Microsoft or Obsidian is teasing anything just yet. But at the very least, Obsidian will be able to breathe a sigh of relief, knowing that for the first time in its history, it will be able to develop games without having to worry if its next game will be the studio's last.